Hello, and welcome back to Rogue Legacy, where there is this so far unbeatable menace in the castle still that goes by the name of Sir Ponce de Leon. And I'm sick and tired of him because we just can't seem to beat him. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna choose a hero and we are going to try and beat him. And I think that Lady Schnuff III has an excellent chance over here. And let us see quickly if we have any new gear available. I don't think we have. And yeah, we're equipped to the best of our abilities to deal with Sir Ponce de Leon. So what we shall do is we shall equip our haste rune there. So we have the right speed. And I guess we should spend some money on unlocking, like, I don't know. We don't really need any particular runes anywhere. So I guess we could use a few dash runes. Like there. And like there. Just so that we have those available for switching out. I don't think we can buy anything else. Nope. So yeah, what we're gonna do, and just before you ask. Yes, we could use the architect and try quite a few boss runs, or Sir Ponce de Leon runs with him, because we would know where to go. But I absolutely dislike the idea of having to give up any profits to the architect, you know? I mean, it's not like we need the money, but I don't feel like giving it away either. Besides, we can still use it to buy runes, right? So, what we're gonna do is we're not going to use the architect, and we are going to try and do a series of Sir Ponce de Leon attempts. Because, honestly, I think we have it in us to kill Sir Ponce de Leon. It's just that, well, you know, we need practice at it. I mean, we've had a few, few attempts at Sir Ponce de Leon. That was stupid. We had a few quite solid attempts at Sir Ponce de Leon. And I think that by now we have mastered the mechanics of the fight and... mastered. Clearly we haven't, but there have been some runs where we were in control. It's just that some, well, you know, bad luck on our part caused us to take, you know, fatal damage. And, well, you know, whenever I am fatal, then, well, you know, clearly we haven't done what we were supposed to do. And that is kill Sir Ponce de Leon and actually survive the fight. So, we'll just go rush... Oh, okay, apparently the tower is not there. I mean, before this, you know, I think it's safe to say that our strategy was like, you know, getting stats to make the fight easier for ourselves. Clearly, though, you know, well, that's gonna take forever. And I just want to kill him. He is more than overdue, you know. His death is, at least. Alright, that's you gone. Let's see, is the tower over here? No, it isn't, so we'll actually just go back, you know. We are not going to clear out every room here. I just want Sir Ponce de Leon to be dead. That's all, and... I hope that Sir Schnuff is going to be the one to do that. Now, we do need to be a little bit more careful over here. Oh, man, I thought that that would not hit us. Oh, balls. We do have a few statue, or a few. One statue that gives us guaranteed HP. Alright, so far so good. There is our HP back. Ooh. Yeah, tricky, huh? I mean, the other thing is, you know, what I feel like, kind of, I wouldn't say rushing exactly, but why I feel like we should be just focusing for the boss is that we've been blazing through the tower. Ow. With very good success. Not only the tower, the castle and the garden as well. You know, they haven't proven to be any challenge for us recently. I should be a lot more careful though, you know, in the tower, as we can lose HP over here much more quickly. Alright, so far so good. What we need to do really over here is find the boss room, which probably... well, this is actually an easy room. Alright. That's you gone. So, yeah, you know, I mean, just doing, you know, a rush to the boss, I don't think that's that, you know, bad, well, bad for what we want to achieve in the game. Ooh, you aren't even dead in one hit. You are right now, though. Right, looking good so far, you know? I mean, we're making good progress. Sure, we've lost some HP, but it's not something terrible. Alright, you won't... Nice one. Nice one. I mean, I'm not gonna take any risks, you know, getting that money. We don't need it. We're also not gonna kill the paintings. We don't have to. Ooh, that didn't actually kill you. And I really think that spike ball should have been destroyed, basically. Right, okay, all we need to do is go down here, where we do not find our boss room. Ooh, we don't even kill though. In one hit, yeah. That was just stupid. What I should have done over there is use our special ability. Alas, I did not, so... Alright, no boss room. See what we're doing here? This is a very different strategy than what we were doing before. Also, I mean, thank the Lord for double jump. Ow. Ah, I thought that we would be able to get away with that. Alright, alright. Break some interior here. Boss room, please. No boss room. Okay, so the boss room could be anywhere. I guess it's best if we go and explore up here as well to the left. I mean, it could be anywhere, so it could also be up there, apparently. Also, we should not expect to kill those with two hits for very much longer. I mean, as a paladin, you know, we do okay damage. And that's also, you know, that's about it. Okay. Not great. Okay. Now, the good thing about us still having loads and loads of the castle and even... Okay, never mind. You know, loads and loads of the castle and even the garden as a whole... Nice. Available is that we can always go back there to get some HP. Which I guess we actually should do, to be honest, as we have the boss room here. Right, let's get some easy kills then. And not lose any more HP than we have lost already. Also, enemies are the most excellent source of HP, as it's consistent. So we should try and do a few room clearings over here. Alright, let's see. Chicken legs, plicks. Ooh, I saw... Whoa, I saw that one coming. Alright. Alright. We're going very well with our HP. I don't want to enter the boss room. Nice. Alright, very nice. What was I about to say? Like, I don't want to enter the boss room with less than full HP, so... Yeah, we do need to get that. I want to give ourselves the best possible chance to beat Sir Ponce de Leon. We'll probably die a couple of times, but I do hope to finally get him down, you know. It's really... Oh, man, it's just... It's overdue. We need him dead. ASAP. So, yeah, let's see how this goes. Hope everything goes well. I also, you know, with the flames, I do have, like, some strategy for it. Okay, that was bad. Okay. Nice. So those are, like, two hits. Wow, the concentration, man, it's real. So long as we dodge in a very effective way, we should not see these flames coming really balls. I saw it happening and then I was like, balls. That was dangerous. Now, I think most of the spike balls are actually dead already. At least the ones that could pose a problem for us. Balls. Right, that one was unfortunate. But, ooh, nice. Nice. Oh, that was also very bad. Alright, we can't take any hit now. So we should just play it careful. Right, going well so far. Don't get hit by that spike ball. That would be the death of us. Nice. Ooh. Don't get hit now. Dodge the flames. Nice. Nice! What is this? Oh my good lord! Wow! We actually did it! Oh my good lord! So, ladies and gentlemen, that is what happens when you're sick and tired of a boss. Let the anger, let the rage fuel your quest for the truth. We did it. Nice! Wow! I mean, I have like a heartbeat of like 200,000 and a million right now. I am super excited, you know. How much money did we actually got from Sir Ponce de Leon? We got 4,330 right now. Let us see, right? A good 6,110. Wow. Oh, man. Yes. We did it. And we have this treasure chest over here. It is, I mean, wow. I've been struggling with this boss for so long. And now, we just did it, you know. I was like, yeah, no, not gonna do it anymore. Sick and tired of it. And then, boom, shakalaka. We did it! Hooray! Alright, enough. Let's see what we got. That's not really what I was after, but I'll take it nonetheless. We did it! Nice! Oh man, that is good. That is beyond good. The door is closed now. We are awesome. Oh, and did I tell you, by the way, that we are awesome? So, what are we gonna do now then, huh? Well, for one thing, I am very glad we didn't take the architect. What we're gonna do now is just leisurely try and kill everything everywhere else, basically. So we're just gonna take an easy stroll through the rest of the castle, severing our victory. It is Sir Schnuff III who finally managed to achieve the inachievable. That was like our main obstacle, and now we did it! We did it! Oh man, I'm excited. In case you didn't tell, I am happy, you know. This is great! This is beyond great! This is excellent! Finally, we're making some good progress over here, man. I honestly thought that it would take us like another 30 videos or so to do this. But no, we did not. We actually managed to kill Sir Ponce de Leon. Bye-bye. Check it out. Oh, that is just so good. Even if we die right here, right now, you know, I wouldn't mind at the slightest. Honestly, you know, this is what I've been waiting for so incredibly long. It is amazing. Sir Schnuff III, you will be one of the very few legendary heroes. You know, when you go back to look at your family's history, you'll see that we have a lot of divine members of the family. But there are only a select few legendary heroes. And I can safely tell you that Sir Schnuff III will be one of them. So, yeah, good for us, huh? Get some money over here and then just walk along here. Not gonna do anything fancy. This is just gonna be me leisurely strolling through the castle, through the garden, through whatever remains of the tower, and then finally as well into the dungeon, as that is the next place of interest for us. But man, did I tell you, by the way, how amazing it is to actually kill Sir Ponce de Leon? You dead! Me not! Alright, very good. Okay, is there anything else left here that we might want to check? Probably not, so we'll go and... That was bad damage on my part. That was really bad. Shouldn't have taken that, you know, kind of wanted to jump there. I thought he wouldn't hit us. Right, so what is this prayer statue? We'll take it. Ew! What? Ponce de Leon's obol. Wow. You know, for a while, I thought that this was when the castle was generated, you know, everything would be set. It would be procedurally generated each and every time. But obviously, the rewards are also generated randomly each and every time you actually open a reward chest. As that statue clearly shows, because we could not have gotten the obol without us killing Sir Ponce the Lion. However, he is dead right now, though, so... Oh, man. Oh, nice, nice. Oh, hello there, zombie. Bye there, zombie. Don't mind if I kill you. Don't mind if I do. Right. Look at us, though. Steamrolling. Oh, that was bad. That was very bad. You know, note to self, don't just fall down whilst you don't know what is below. Note to self. Well. I mean, I'm pretty sure we'll do just fine for the rest. I mean, we got some guaranteed chicken legs coming up with the transition room to the garden, as well as the actual boss room of the garden. So... I mean, I don't see us losing out here, you know. Well, I see us dying in the dungeon easily, but... Man, this is big, you know. This is really, really big for me. Honestly, I did not expect that this... Oh, nice. Look, see? More HP. All of a sudden, we're doing just mighty fine. Oh. Hello there. I did not... Balls. I did not notice you up there, but... Oh. You are going to shoot now, are you? I don't mind if you do. Can we... Our spells are, like, abysmally... Ouch. Are abysmally weak, so... I don't think that using our spell to accomplish anything is a good idea, but... Also, the conducting electricity really well is quite helpful in that room. Right, okay, another chicken leg puts us back where we were in terms of HP, using the terrain to our advantage, and there we go. Yes. This is it, man. This could be... Oh, man, this is a milestone. This is... You don't know how much this means to me. Have we cleared everything out over here? I don't think we have. We have cleared it up to this point. Wow, that was the most dumb move. The fact that I got away with it is just... Man, today I have angels sitting on every shoulder that I have. Granted, don't take me for a mutant by that weird phrasing, though, because I don't have any more shoulders than you do. Usually, you only have two. I am no different in that regard. Alright. Easy kill. You should be dead as well pretty soon. And, yeah, just strolling along, you know, don't mind me. I killed your boss, so, what up, huh? Oh, man. Hey, so Ponce de Leon, how you doing now that you're dead? Huh? Yeah. Not just dead, like completely busted. Like, we rushed it in there and we came out the victor. Alright, we'll go back for that. Like that, done. Such a burden from my shoulders. Oh, this is also really nice and easy. This is one reason why I love this trade, you know. Not all trades are good. This one definitely is, you know. It's like a factor for... well, you know... balls, man. I'm so bad at using our special ability. That's one of my, I wouldn't say faults, but you know, definitely something that I could improve my gameplay on is use special abilities more, and actually like spells in general, you know. Ooh, hey, well that's nice. So what we got so far is basically it's like we found 4 fairy chests already on this run. So that's not bad, you know. I mean, even if we did not kill Sir Ponce de Leon, from a stat upgrade point, we've done already quite good in this run. But, well, you know, did you know, by the way, that we actually killed Sir Ponce de Leon? In case you did not know, we did! Wow. Oh, man. Slowly but surely, you know, I'm getting used to this world where our nemesis is dead. I also consider Sir Ponce de Leon to be one of the harder boss. Whoa! Hello there, thanks for not landing directly onto my head. I mean, you definitely were trying to, I saw that one. I saw that much. Nice. You dead. You dead too. Okay, I mean that slime was, whoa, I mean that, wow, I'll have to look that back, you know, when I'm editing the video, but it definitely seemed that in the real world, we should have taken an arrow to the head, and with an open visor like we have, I dare say that would be pretty fatal. Also, the garden. Very nice place when you need some HP. It's littered with chicken legs and juicy enemies that have HP. As our HP shows, because we've gone from near death to, well, to actually a pretty good HP standpoint, at least where we currently are. Oh, there's multiples of you. Do you mind if I absolutely obliterate you, as I've done with everything else so far? Especially of this one foe, you know, Sir Ponce the Lion. Oh man, we killed him. I'm not gonna gamble away our hard-earned 6,100-something gold game bucks cash coins, because we earned them the hard way, and I'm gonna enjoy spending every penny that we got. Also, you know, this just basically changes our whole strategy for the game. Because I was using, like, some kind of meta strategy before, you know. And, ooh, wow, that was some really, really imba dodging that we did there. No, but like I was saying, you know, I was playing some kind of meta game here when it came to Sir Ponce the Leon. And being ready for that boss fight. And, well, you know, I'll actually go into detail on what that meta is. I might have explained it before, you know. There was plenty of time for me to explain my strategies, as we took forever to kill that boss. But my plan was, you know, and up till now, I mean, now we got a new plan. But my plan was to just farm a fairy chest, you know. Get better stats whilst Sir Ponce the Leon would stay at the same stats. See, the thing here is with this game is that there's like a every time, oh, that was really bad. Every time that we buy an upgrade at the mansion, the game becomes harder, you know. We are balls, did not want to kill you. No, but every time that we buy a stat upgrade over there, then the game gets harder. And the fairy chests are actually us, you know, becoming stronger while the game stays the same. We're not going to attempt that, not with our current HP. Besides, we don't really need to go after these difficult fairy chests, you know what I mean? Why would we? As we have already gained 4 fairy chests. Oh wow, there's actually like this massive horse over there. Well, at least there was. Alright, that's you dead. That's you dead. That's also, the name of that beast is a nightmare. Clever naming there, as Cellular Games. Very creative, you know. Totally got that punt. So. No, but, you know, that was the strategy, to just accrue fairy chests till the point where we would have been easily able to beat Sir Ponce de Leon. Now that we have beaten him, though, our strategy is going to change. As I know the last boss fight, I know it quite well, in fact. And I also know that there is a certain strategy that, well, to say that it cheeses the boss fight a little bit, well, I guess there's something to be said for that strategy to cheese it a little bit. There is a certain class for the last boss fight that makes that whole fight incredibly easy with the mechanics that it has. Now, it also doesn't, you know, it makes it that easy that the difficulty of it doesn't really matter that much. So, what we're gonna do now is just buy stat upgrades, you know. I mean, it doesn't really matter that much anymore. We can buy whatever we like and get stronger and better. In fact, you know, and that's another thing, we actually need to buy quite a few specific stat upgrades for our strategy to even work. So, yeah, I mean, the whole game changes right now. We can buy whatever we like and, you know, it's fine. It's finally, the moment is there. Of course, fairy chests are still good. See, there's like this curve, you know. See that if you were to buy the strat upgrades, get stronger, the game gets harder, you know. If you would put that in a formula, like, you know, power increase by divided square root of game difficulty, you'd see that there is like a curve, you know, of, okay, so you buy this much and then the game gets this much harder, but you become that much stronger. So the real effective relative difficulty is like X, you know, and it, the more you buy, it develops itself into this kind of curve. And my general feeling of the game, and mind you, I have played this game quite a lot, my general feeling of that is that the game actually becomes harder the more you buy a stat upgrade. So, through dimension, you know, if you buy a lot of stat upgrades over there, you're actually making... Oh, balls. You're actually making the game quite a lot harder. Fairy chests are like the only way to counter that. So they are still a very good thing to go after, you know. You will want them each and every time you can get them. They're never bad, so to say. So it's definitely something, you know, that we need to keep in mind. But at least for the next boss, doesn't really matter if the game gets that much harder. So, yeah. That's our new strategy. Just buying the stuff that we want. And also buying the stuff that we actually need. Oh man, this is gonna be a new era for Rogue Legacy. Finally, we shall be making some progress. Right, I think I can fight you a lot better over here. Right, you saw him charge towards us at the end. Long live the double jump, as we don't need to worry ourselves about the spikes at all. Oh, well, double jump, triple jump, you know, it's just a detail, but... Another thing that greatly helped out with the Sir Ponce the Lion fight is the fact that this, you know, triple jump that we have is what I play the game in my own time with as well. You know, when I don't record it in my private save. So I'm really used to having it, and well, you know, it kind of showed because I was in optima forma. Probably still am, actually, seeing how well we're doing. I mean, the tower does not pose any threat to us. Sure, I've taken some dumb damage, but that's just because I am in a victory rush, you know, currently. I mean, even if we just die right now because of walking into a spike repeatedly, you know, for multiple times in a row, then I still wouldn't feel bad, because this run cannot go south anymore. We have already achieved the one thing that I wanted to achieve. Everything else that we get right now is pure bonus. Bonus on top of what? In case you did miss it, bonus on top of killing Sir Ponce de Leon. Yes, he is dead. Dead, forever dead. And man, am I glad for it. Right. You know what would really sweeten this? If we actually find some pieces of gear in like the dungeon. I'm pretty sure that we will make it to the dungeon. So, oh, hello there, eyes. You are highly annoying. I did actually kill a few of them. That will kill you. That will not kill you. That one will, though. We're not going to get the money, as we just physically cannot get it. Oh, hello there. Mind if I slash you in two, or whatever many pieces you dissipate in? Oh. I did press the attack once more button, but it just didn't trigger. Doesn't matter, the painting is long dead anyway, but still, you know, just wanted to point it out there. Now, there is a thing that, you know, my current setup, and I'm not talking about the game here, but more like my computer hardware, that kind of stuff setup, is actually lacking. And it's a bit technical, but since we are here on a victory rush now anyway, I might as well go into detail about what the actual handicap is. And that's the fact that I play on a USB keyboard, and for a moment I thought that you would actually cause us a lot of grief because you would be able to shoot through there. No, but I play this game on a in general, everything I do, you know, I have a USB keyboard, wireless thing, you know, great as well. And but the thing is that because it's USB, there is a limit to the amount of simultaneous input strokes that it can record. And you know what? I mean, I'm not a geek thing, nerd, computer expert, or whatever you want to call it. But I have looked... Ooh, I thought for a moment we would get in there. Now, I have looked into this. The thing is, with the USB keyboard input, that the USB signal apparently has to go through like some clock tick step things, you know, on the hardware side of things. So what that means is that any simultaneous input always has to be processed sequential. Now, I don't know the actual frequency and clock tick rate stuff shizzles, but what I do know is that because it's sequential, and well, you know, there's other things that also use the USB, like for example, my microphone is USB. There is like, you know, and there's only like a certain band. There's only a certain bandwidth for the USB thing available. What's happening with it is that when I press too many keys at once or in rapid succession, it does not put the signals through anymore. However, there is a remedy for that. One, you can buy a non-USB keyboard, you know, one of those PS2 keyboards. The other thing you can do is get yourself an actual converter from USB to PS2. And I do have that lying around. So, yeah, that's exactly what I wanted you to do. I do have that lying around somewhere. Balls. But I, well, you know, the thing is that, I wouldn't say recently, but like a couple of months ago, I did kind of do like a house renovation with painting the walls and whatnot and clearing out all the furniture and everything. So all my stuff is in boxes on the attic. And I'm sure there is a... Oh, crap. I thought you would die in two hits. That was my own idiocy. I should have been more careful there. Well, it went with all the hits, actually. No, but I know I do have one of those PS2... one of those USB to PS2 converter plug things, you know. You need, like, the purple ones, the green ones are for the mouse. I do have them somewhere. I just can't find them. And that's when, you know, occasionally, in a game like this, where sometimes out of panic you press, like, quite a few buttons and, well, then what could happen is that the, you know, the actual response that you want from the keyboard actually isn't there. Tricked you, and you didn't trick me. No, so that's why occasionally, you know, I press like an attack button, which happened God knows how many rooms before this one, and then just nothing happens, basically. So... with that, you know, said and explained, I still think we did great, because with a USB keyboard that's suboptimal for these type of games, we still managed to do it. And, well, you know, there's like one other game that I'm really, well, I wouldn't say into, but man, do I enjoy watching it. And no, that's a boss room, by the way. See, there's those big dudes there. We're not gonna do any of these mini bosses today, as I don't wanna spoil our great victory by stupidly dying on one of those bosses. No, but anyway, what I was saying is that, you know, even with us having a USB keyboard and doesn't. Possibly not every command that we put in being perceived by the computer. We did finish the boss. We killed him. We finished him off. Anyway, I am going to get one of those PS2 converters. By the way, if you're also curious why a PS2 keyboard actually does get the direct input, it's because it's a separate thing. I don't know what you call it. Interfacer? Oh, balls. Interfacer something, you know. Yeah, I saw that one coming. That's just bad damage on my part. Should have used the special ability. No, but the reason why the PS2 does get direct input is because it's its own separate interface, specifically designed to deal with stuff like keyboard and mouse input. Nice. And that's another fairy chest. And this magic damage is now actually really helpful for us. Okay, so the dungeon. I don't know. We went through the castle and the garden and the tower with great relative ease. But currently, in the dungeon, it seems like we've forgotten how to play all of a sudden. We should be really careful here. I mean, this is no joke. This is the last area of the game. So we can expect things to be tough over here. Alright, let's see. Where is our safe spot? Not over there. Balls. I should have known that. One hit and we're dead. Does that matter? Of course it matters, you know. I mean, how cool would it be if we now kill the very last boss as well? I mean, that would be just insane. To be honest. Okay. Okay. Wow, look at that zombie. Look at everything being tough over here as well. Now, what I want to know, I want to see where the hits of those enemies land. See, I did saw something landing over here. That's why we... Oh, man. Oh, that was really stupid. But it doesn't matter. Oh, it was actually a lady. Excuse me, Lady Schnuff III. It should be Sir Schnuff, but man, it's a shame I don't have a mouse pointer, but I would point out that very big ball of fire that we killed as Lady Schnuff III. Retribution runes can damage invulnerable objects. Wow, that's actually quite fitting, as that has been a key part of our gearing strategy for defeating Sir Ponce de Leon. Without retribution, we would have ran into those spike balls a lot more often. Not this time, though. We killed Sir Ponce de Leon. Lady Schnuff is one of the very few legendary heroes that we have. So, I guess, you know, a new era awaits us. But that and more is all for next time, when we play more Rogue Legacy.